Hello, hello, everybody. Welcome to your weekly messages for November 24th to the 30th of 2019. It's the last week of November, and then we're in the tail end of 2019. Holy smokes. All right. So before we get started, just so you know that 2020 readings are going to be coming out December 1st. So take a moment to subscribe if you haven't already. If you want to get an overview of 2020, that will be coming soon. And if you are interested in a tarot pop-up, which I will be offering sometime in December, but I will be doing like a small offering for tarot in December. Sign up for my newsletter so you know when that happens and you stay up to date on everything else. And you also get a weekly reading sent to your inbox every Sunday. All right, other than that, I'm going to go ahead and pull some oracle cards for you. I have a coupon code for all the affirmator stuff if you're interested. It's in the description box. But let's see what's coming up for you this week. Joy! To enjoy something, I simply need to add joy to it. Joy is like butter. I can put it on anything and it'll make it way better. Today, I will add joy to everything. Really slather it on. Today, I'm the Orville Redenbacher of joy. And life's popcorn is about to get it. Okay. So this is also about finding and cultivating joy. So however you're able to do that, that seems to be the project for you this week and something you can really tap into. Let's see what else we have coming up. I can decide today to recalibrate my energy and commit to love and joy. Okay, so very, very similar. I think that things are really lightening up now that we're shifting into Sagittarius season. You know, it makes it way lighter when we move into that energy. You know, Scorpio energy wants to bring all of that shadow up to the surface. And so now that we've shifted out of that, it seems that there's a lot of celebrating happening. It seems like there's things to look forward to. You know, some of you, right, the holidays are bittersweet if you're dealing with holiday stuff. But ultimately, I think that it's about just making the shifts wherever you can. Like this card says, recalibrate. You know, don't worry about being at an ultimate joy, happiness, celebration 24/7. But you can recalibrate your energy. Okay, let's see what else is going on. The Emperor. Okay, so this is Divine Masculine. I'm getting that there is some discipline happening here. I mean that in a good way. Like, how are you showing up for yourself? How are you showing up for the things that are important to you? And it seems like that's really a focus this week. And then we also have King of Swords, doing it your way, not worrying so much about whether or not other people would take the same approach, but really just honoring your own decision-making this week and what feels best, right, and true for you. That's going to be the most important piece. And then we also have the Eight of Wands. So things are moving really, really quickly. I think this is kind of like, if you're doing things your own way, things are going to move quickly. Have some conviction in that for yourself. And also know that even if you feel like things are moving slow, if you're doing the work, if you're showing up for yourself, if you're putting in the right type of effort, right? So some of you might need to be putting more energy behind things. Some of you might need to be resting and kind of taking it slow. Either way, that's effort because it takes a lot to change. And so that's what I'm getting, is that even if you're practicing slowing down, that's what's going to help things accelerate. And then we also have the Five of Cups. Okay, it's very easy to fixate on things that are not working. That's where we automatically, our brains want to find a problem all the time. That's what we're designed to focus on so that we can fix it. The brain wants a problem to fix. But the thing is, that's really not good for manifestation, right? If you're going to zoom in on that, it's going to mushroom into more things that feel like crap. So the goal here is to shift, recalibrate, look at the things that are important to you, that do matter to you, and let that be what you focus on. So this is about shifting your attention this week, especially if you're dealing with family stuff. Definitely, definitely finding a way to cope with that for your own sanity. And then we have the Six of Pentacles. Okay, so reciprocity. I would stay away from doing things that really don't feel good. I would recommend setting boundaries this week, right? If someone is just taking, then that can lead to resentment, that can lead to frustration, that can lead to other forms of pain that aren't exactly ideal. So instead of dealing with that friction, it's going to be better for you to set a boundary. The other thing to keep in mind with this is evaluate reciprocation within your relationships, right? Not every relationship is going to be give and take, but if you just keep your eye on it and you have that awareness, you're going to be able to figure out what's right for which relationship for you. And then to clarify this, we have the Seven of Stars. Yeah, so it's kind of like keep your eyes peeled for what makes sense in relationships, for what feels reciprocal. And even the other thing that I'm getting from this is projects as well. Are you investing in a project that doesn't feel good or isn't aligned with you or really just is not? I mean, sometimes you reach a point in a project where you need to get over that hump of resistance or feeling like you're not exactly enjoying what you're doing. That definitely can come up. But really, if you're kind of walking down a path that isn't going to yield any fruit, that's something that you might want to keep in mind as well. Are you enjoying the journey is kind of the message there. I'm also going to clarify the Five of Cups. Queen of Wands. Okay, yeah, so it's really a reminder that you're mastering your energy and where you're putting it, what you're putting it behind, and just getting into the alignment of the things that you want. That's going to be the most important piece of this entire thing. If you want it, like the Emperor is also pointing to, I want this, right? Because this is like hunting, claiming what's yours, putting that energy behind things. And all of this is, you know, a good energy to have, right? We want things to work for. I think this is a really enjoyable part of the human experience, like finding things that you would like to put into the world, like just exciting stuff to work towards. So let's see, I'm gonna do a 3-card pick. You're welcome to ask a question, ask for clarity, guidance, whatever it is that you're needing. Okay, card number one. Five of Wands, my favorite card. Problem solving, conflict, figuring everything out. Being in a space of, we're going to figure out how to make this happen, how to make it work. And this is actually what helps you gain traction, make headway. And overall, it's just in support of you really moving through whatever obstacle might be presenting itself. So this is how you get to solutions. Don't shy away from the conflict element of this. Lean into it to make progress. And then card number two, Five of Pentacles. Working on some scarcity or the, oh no, what if it doesn't work out? I'm getting that this is just highlighting that frame of mind or that part of you that is kind of like the Five of Cups, where it's like, but what if it doesn't happen? What if God doesn't have my back? What if? So it's really, I would spend some time meditating. I would spend some time clearing your head. I would spend some time evaluating it. Are the worst case scenarios ultimately, absolutely, without a doubt, true, or is it just a story? So if you can sift through that and spend a little bit of time finding a new way to view it, that's going to be really helpful to work through that. And then card number three, we have the Seven of Wands. This is working really hard. So trying to basically fight against the current of maybe what you're getting told to do or any type of pressure surrounding you, because this is kind of like down here with all of these other wands. It's kind of like a mob with their pitchforks and torches. That type of energy kind of comes with the Seven of Wands. And so that's what I'm getting, is it's just like you really need to hold your own, especially with that King of Swords. Like, know that what you're doing makes sense. If you're getting pushback from people, it's kind of like, know your truth, own what's best, right, and true for you. And it's okay if other people don't get it. So it's about rising above that and being okay being misunderstood is the energy of this. Because then it's going to, you know, as you kind of reveal your truth more and more, then this is going to soften and it's not going to feel as intense. All right, everybody, that's all that I have for you this week. Don't forget to check out the podcast if you're interested. And all of the links to work with me, all of the decks I've used today, they are listed in the description box below. You're welcome to check them out. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram at Onyx Healing if you want more readings, more content, more good stuff. And don't forget to subscribe so you know when the 2020 readings come out. All right, I will talk to you later, everybody. Bye-bye.